So let's take another look at the accessibility functions on your Mac. A lot of these can be used by everybody. And today we're going to go into System Preferences, Accessibility, and look at Speech. And the top part here decides what voice your Mac uses for speech functions. Now, this is not Siri. Siri is a whole separate system. These are special accessibility functions that can read things out loud to you. And you can choose from a variety of voices. You can go to Customize, and there are a ton of voices you can choose from. Sometimes you need to download them first. They don't come with the system, but they're quick little downloads. So you can switch to these. I find Samantha's the one that's closest to the kind of modern Siri type voice that we're used to. And you can play to hear a sample.
Hello, my name is Samantha.
You can also try different speeds.
Hello, my name. Hello, my name is Samantha.
And get it to where you want it to go. Now, where would you use this kind of thing? Well, for instance, if you can go to any app, really, let's say a web page here, you can select some text, and you can go to Edit, Speech, Start Speaking.
MacMost is a free website with video tutorials for Apple Mac.
Now, there's a keyboard shortcut for this, so you can use Option Escape to actually do this. So now we can go here to the page, Option
Escape. MacMost is a free website with video tutorials.
Option Escape is a handy way to stop it as well. So if you find yourself using this function a lot, turn this on and you can use Option Escape or change the key, the shortcut key for that. Very useful. Here's another place this is used. Enable Announcements. So when you get an alert from an app, instead of just seeing it on the screen, you'll also get it read to you. This can be really handy because sometimes the alerts are hard to see, especially if you've got multiple screens. A few times I've been caught where there's been an alert on a screen I didn't expect and I couldn't quite figure out. It took me a few seconds to figure out where that alert was, what was going on. Now, the default, it's something like 10 seconds or so, which is handy because an alert can appear, you could see it, dismiss it, and it never bothers you. But if you don't notice an alert appears, then after 10 seconds, you have this audio cue here. So let's set it to 0 just to get it working so you hear it all the time. You can choose a different voice, which could be handy if you're using the regular voice or you find Samantha's a little too close to Siri or whatever. You can use something else so you kind of recognize it as an alert. You can also have it say something at the beginning of the alert like the application name or one of these phrases. You can also add your own phrase as well. And you can have it go loop through these phrases here so you don't kind of, you know, hear the same one all the time or pick a random one. So let's go and try this. For instance, in Photos here, I've selected a photo. I'm going to hit the Delete key and it's going to give me an alert warning me about deleting this photo. And now I'll actually get some audio with it as well.
Alert from Photos. Delete from all your devices.
So that's kind of handy. It could be something that you find useful. I would suggest maybe turning it on for a little bit, setting it to 0 seconds, and seeing if it's useful. It's easy enough to turn off. Also, this is easy enough to turn on and off, but you know the Option Escape probably won't get in the way, and it's kind of handy to have text read to you out loud, even if it's just so you can rest your eyes for a minute while having a long email read to you.